Hi, I'm Dan Gadara. I'm a dentist in San Diego County, and this is my E4D PlanScan video channel. Last time we talked about the simplest example of implant crown design, where we turn off autogenesis, apply a small tooth, and then grow it. Today I'm going to talk about more complex cases where we determine ahead of time where we're going with the case by fabricating a Telio CAD provisional using the same grow a tooth technique, and then we replicate it using cloning software to fabricate our final restoration. Now, this presents some special challenges since we're trying to apply a full-size clone to an implant abutment that has a small marginal circumference, and we have the risk of getting that shrink wrap distortion again that we talked about last time. I think this is easily overcome though by using a design technique that I like to call inflate a tooth. While this technique is applicable anytime you use pre-op scan or clone, I think it's essential when you try to clone onto an implant abutment. We begin the case by taking a pickup impression, making a soft tissue model, and scanning the model with temporary abutments placed and the soft tissue removed. Using the grow a tooth technique, and in this case bridge software, we design and then mill a Telio CAD provisional. Go ahead and cement the provisional on the model. Notice how the screw access holes are favorably oriented. Take it to the mouth and work out the excursions and the aesthetics, and send the patient home for a test drive. If any of this doesn't make sense or you want more detail, view the previous blog. In this particular case, I chose to link the abutments with a single restoration, so I wanted to notch up my model accuracy. Before the next appointment, I prepared impression abutments on the model with Duralay, linked them together in the mouth, and took a final pickup impression. Under Scan Model, the new impression with the final abutments placed and the soft tissue model removed needs to be scanned. Under Scan Clone or Pre-op Scan, depending on your software version, you need to scan the provisional placed in the mouth. At the time of this blog, the software is limited to one clone scan, so I can't also scan my soft tissue model as in the last blog. So when we design, we start essentially by doing the same technique as the last blog where we grow a tooth. We turn off autogenesis, we alter some of our shaping parameters, and then we have to use Alt Down to create a small tooth so we don't get that shrink wrap appearance at the margin. And then we apply it. This design, I've already finished number 6, so we're just going to focus on number 5. Now it's time for inflate a tooth. Notice here, first of all, that we haven't applied any clone library to this abutment. It's purely applying a small tooth so that we get a good, smooth proposal that we can now inflate. The tools we use for inflate a tooth are slice plane, rubber tooth, and clone overlay, and smooth tooth. I found that incremental tool changes do not work as well as freeform and using rubber tooth for inflating a tooth. So what we do is we go under rubber tooth, we go under our clone overlay, and we start inflating our tooth. Now, there's a variety of ways you can inflate it. You can just try to grab it and start bringing it out, but a more exquisite way to do it is to use slice plane and to grab the proposal and bring it out to the overlay created by the pre-op scan. Now, the first time you inflate the tooth, you can be pretty gross with it, because in a minute here, we're gonna be using smooth the tooth to bring it back to the location of the stent or the clone scan. All right, so now we're ready for smoothing the tooth. Now, in the first time through you smooth the tooth, you can be very aggressive with your smoothing. And you'll notice as you run it around the proposal, it brings it back to the location of the pre-op scan stent that we've created. And so we want to do that aggressively. Now let's look and see what we've accomplished. Here you can see that our proposal has shrunk back this much from our stent, but it's not a lot. So we can bring it back out again, still do it in a fairly gross manner. There's some areas that don't want to smooth out very well with smooth tooth, so it's better just to use rubber tooth to bring them closer in line. Now the second time we go back and use our smooth tooth, we want to turn down the intensity because we want to get closer to the line of our stent. Let's see what we've managed to accomplish now on that facial aspect. Now you can see how much closer now our proposal has come to the stent. Very close now. In some areas you might want to adjust. And it just depends on how close you really want to get this thing. But we know we're really close right here, so the intensity of smooth tooth is going to be really attenuated now because we just want to take it back a little bit. All right, let's see what we've managed to accomplish now. See how close we are now? That light amount of smooth tooth has really aligned our template and our design. I think you understand the concept of inflated tooth. We inflate it using rubber tooth, and then we bring it back using smooth tooth, occasionally checking to see how we're doing with slice plane. In areas that don't seem to conform well, we can manipulate with rubber tooth. But again, if you try to do all your design with rubber tooth and slice plane, you're gonna end up with a ripple effect, and that's why it's important to bring in smooth tooth to help give you a more even design. So when the design is complete, we mill it, try it in on the soft tissue model after crystallization, stain, glaze, and in this case, add a little pink porcelain. Prepare it for cementation and then cement it on the model. The last blog goes into much more detail on this. Try it in the mouth and make any adjustments, and then torque it down.
So I hope there's something today that I've told you that you find helpful. In my next segment, I'm going to direct it more towards newer users and talk about the virtues of negative eyedropper. So until next time, I hope you thrive in your practice.